Nor heaven nor earth hath been at peace tonight. Thrice hath Calpurnia in her sleep cried out, "Help, ho! They murder Caesar."
Who's within?
My lord.
Go bid the priests do present sacrifice, and bring me their opinions of success.
I will, my lord.
What mean you, Caesar? Think you to walk forth? You shall not stir out of your house today.
Caesar shall forth! Things that threaten me ne'er looked but on my back. When they shall see the face of Caesar, they are vanished.
Caesar, I never stone ceremonies, yet now they frighten me. There is one with them. Besides the things we've heard and seen, recounts the most horrid sights seen by the watch. A lioness hath welted in the streets, and graves have yawned and yielded up their dead. Fierce fiery warriors fought upon the clouds, and raced in squadrons in bright form of war. Drizzled blood upon the capital. Noise of battle hurtled in the air. Horses did neigh, and dying men did groan. And ghosts did shriek and squeal about the streets. Oh, Caesar, these things are beyond all use, and I do fear them.
What can be avoided, his
end is purposed by the mighty gods. Yet Caesar shall go forth, for these predictions are to the world in general as to Caesar.
When beggars die, there are no comets seen. The heavens themselves blaze forth with death of princes.
Cowards die many times before their deaths. The valiant ne'er taste of death but once. Above all the wonders that I yet have heard, it seems to me most strange that men should fear, seeing that death, a necessary end, will come when it will come. What say the augurers?
They would not have you to stir forth today. Hugging the entrails of an offering forth, they could not find a heart within the beast.
The gods do this in shame of cowards. Caesar should be a beast without a heart if he should stay at home today for fear. No, Caesar shall not. Danger knows full well that Caesar's more dangerous than he. We are two lions littered in one day, and I the elder and more terrible. And Caesar shall go forth.
Alas, my lord, your wisdom is consumed in confidence. Do not go forth today. Call my fear that keeps you in the house, and not your own. We shall send Mark Antony to the Senate House, and he shall say you are not well today. Let me, upon my knee, prevail in this.
Mark Antony shall say that I am not well, and for thy humor, I will stay at home today. Here's Decius Brutus.
He shall tell them so.
Caesar, all hail. Good morrow, worthy Caesar. I come to fetch you to the Senate House.
And you are come in very happy time to bid my greeting to the senators, and to tell them that I will not come today. Cannot is false, and that I dare not falser. I will not come today. Tell them so, Decius.
Say he is sick.
Shall Caesar send a lie? Have I in conquest stretched mine arms so far to be afeard to tell greybeards the truth? No. Decius, go tell them that Caesar will not come.
Most mighty Caesar, let me know some cause, lest I be laughed at when I tell them so.
The cause is in my whip. I will not come. That is enough to satisfy the Senate. But for your private satisfaction, because I love you, I will let you know. Calpurnia here, my wife, stays me at home. She dreamt tonight she saw my statue, which like a fountain with 100 spouts did run pure blood, and many lusty Romans came smiling and did bathe their hands in it. And these does she apply for warnings and portents and evils imminent, and on her knee hath begged that I will stay at home.
This dream is all misinterpreted. It was a vision fair and fortunate. Your fountains, in which so many smiling Romans bathed, signifies that from you great Rome shall suck reviving blood, and that great men shall press for tinctures, stains, relics, and cognizance. This by Calpurnia's dream is signified.
And this way have you well expounded it.
I have, when you have heard what I can say, the Senate have concluded to give this day a crown to mighty Caesar. If you shall send them word you will not come, their minds may change. Besides, it were a mock apt to be rendered for someone to say, break up the Senate till another time when Caesar's wife may have better dreams. If Caesar hides himself, shall they not whisper, lo, is Caesar afraid? Pardon me, Caesar, for my dear, dear love for you. Proceedings. Bids me tell you this, and reason to my love is liable.
Thank you.
Your gods,